Hi folks, Vipin here. I'll be making a video about how the railway budget actually happens. Now, I'll try to keep the video as simple as possible and I'll not get into the technical aspect of this. And when I say the technical aspect, I mean I'm not going to talk about whether the budget was a good one or a bad one, that opinion's kept aside, and I'll not even consider the actual way in which the railways in fact makes money, all that. I'll not get into too much of the details. So let me first tell you in fact why the railway budget is done first, and then you have the financial budget, the fiscal budget that actually happens. Now, that's a tradition that we've been following ever since the British established the railways in India. Now, apart from tradition, another reason why we actually do that is because the sheer size of the railways itself requires us to have a separate budget for this institution. So you can imagine how gigantic this institution actually is for it to have its own separate budget. Now, yesterday Sadananda Gowda said that there are about 10 lakh plus employees who are hired in the Indian Railways. Now, 10 lakh employees is a lot, and the railways as an institution caters to more than 100 crore people in this country. Because of this vastness of this institution, it's quite sensible to have a separate budget where you go about allotting the necessary resources through this budget. Now, let me tell you how the budget actually gets designed. Okay, so I'll consider this from Bangalore point of view. Since I am from Bangalore, I'm sorry, I have to be partial towards my city. So, you have a system which is called Management Information System. Now, you guys might have studied that in your graduation, and this is where you actually see the importance of Management Information System. Now, when you talk about Management Information System, it refers to how a manager, or in this case a minister, okay, is going to go about getting resources or getting information from the different sources. Now, the different sources here are, for example, the various stations that are there in the entire country. Now, for example, if I consider the Bangalore station, now Bangalore happens to be a pretty major junction, so the divisional head here will file reports where he'll go about talking regarding the number of people who come, okay, the number of trains which are actually required, the requirement and improvement of facilities. All that is something that is discussed by the divisional managers. Now, they go about publishing a report from their side. That is, they say that, okay, in Bangalore station we need the following. Now, for example, the number of people who travel from Mysore to Bangalore on a daily basis is a lot. So, the divisional manager could actually publish a report saying, last year we had about 10,000 people every day coming from Mysore to Bangalore for work. Now, this year the increase in passengers is from 10,000 to say 20,000. That's nearly that's about 100% improvement in the number of people coming from Mysore to Bangalore. Now, he could go about showing the statistics. It's not difficult. You can show the ticket sales, and you can always show there is an increase in the number of people coming from Mysore to Bangalore for work. So you can show that, okay, the number of trains right now is not adequate to support the number of people who are actually traveling. So he could go about requesting add more trains to the Bangalore-Mysore, the trains between Bangalore and Mysore. Now, this is something which the divisional guys go about suggesting. Okay, the divisional guys go about suggesting this. Now, again, the divisional guys will go about suggesting other things. Like, for example, the station requires improvement in terms of infrastructure. You will always find that because, since the number of people who travel in the railways is a lot, the infrastructure needed for the system is obviously going to be a lot. So, by looking at the number of passengers who commute every day, you can always map out what is the infrastructure requirement. Say, more senior citizens are traveling, you have differently abled people who are traveling, so we need a mechanism, a ramp for getting their wheelchairs on board. You can also request that, okay, a specialized train or a mechanism where people who are using a wheelchair can actually get on board. By looking at all these things that happen on a daily basis, these guys go about publishing a report to the railway minister. Now, the railway minister has a bit of a challenge. It's not always possible to listen to the demands of all the different station managers, the division managers. Now, that is obvious because the number of resources that the railway minister can allot is always limited. And people always go about making unlimited demands. So it's not really possible for the railway minister, anyone, be it Sadananda Gowda or Lalu Prasad Yadav, it's not really possible for any of them to satisfy the requirements of all the railway stations across the country. So this is one thing they could do. They can look at what are the demands they can actually satisfy, which will actually result in a big benefit to the entire country. Now, like for example, the trains increase in the number of trains from Bangalore to Mysore. Now, that's going to be a big improvement because it will also give you additional revenue, because more passengers mean, of course, more revenue for the Indian Railways. So that's something they can actually consider. So they could go about looking at things which is actually going to help the economy from a macro point of view. Okay, a macro point of view. This is something which they actually look at. The other things which they actually looked at is, for example, Sadananda Gowda even suggested that let's have privatization for the housekeeping services. Now, people might ask, okay, why actually go about doing that? Why have the private sector come in? Now, my argument for that is, when you have the private sector actually take up housekeeping, they will certainly do a better job. I've seen professional housekeeping services and they are outstanding. So, if Sadananda Gowda were to take up these services, you will see that the train systems in India are a lot cleaner than what they were before. So, that could mean the number of people who are interested to travel in the railways will be a lot more. Many people, including myself, don't like to travel in trains because of the cleanliness factor that comes there. Now, because of this, I and many others are not using the railways. But if they were to be clean, certainly, I would also become a customer for the Indian Railways, a passenger on board the Indian Railways. This is how they go about designing that budget. They look at the various sources where you can actually improve your revenue. And in order to go about improving your revenue, actually need to go about making investments. So, you add cleanliness there, more people will come. You add security factor, more people will come. In fact, a lot of ladies refuse to travel in the railways because of the lack of security that is there. And I don't blame them. So there is a big market which you are not actually looking at from this. Now, this is what they actually consider. Let's improve the security. More women will come. So when more women actually travel, of course, it means more revenue. This is what they actually look at when they go about designing the budget. The other things that they consider, like for example, Wi-Fi, for example, having a food court in the railway station, all that is going to boost the tourism revenue for this country. You will have a lot of people, techies, foreigners would be interested to use these benefits like Wi-Fi in the train. Now, when they go about using this, that's going to add to the revenue of the Indian Railways. This is how they go about designing some of these interesting things in the railway budget. So, I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any queries regarding this, do let me know. I've tried to keep the video as short as possible because I really do want to get into the technicals of how the budget works, because that is a bouncer for a lot of people and I don't really want to bore you all with that. So, thank you for your time. Have a nice day. Bye.